Hey guys, greetings of the day from Intellipaat. So you must all be using or rather creating outstanding dashboards for your organizations using Tableau, right? But then how well do you really know the features of Tableau? Well, so in this video, we are going to look at some 9 amazing features about Tableau that you probably don't know while using it. Let's begin then. So starting it off with revision history, and then this interesting feature of Tableau helps the users to, let's say, see how workbooks and data sources have changed over time. So each time a user saves or rather publishes any content, the version will be saved by Tableau server. And also, all the previous versions remain intact. That is to say, along with your current version, you also have got control of all the previous versions, which is great. So revision history actually gives confidence to the user to keep experimenting with their content, knowing that their older versions are available. But then, to access this feature, you really need to have an administrator access. And now let me show you guys how actually it is done. So to view revision history, you can simply select work and then click on action menu. And then go to revision history, and then you can simply see the revision history of that workbook. So that simple it is. And here again, you have got a facility of setting or giving the limit of the number of revisions as well. I hope that's clear now. Let's move forward then. Now, you also must have used index function in Tableau. Okay. But then did you know that using the same index function, you can create a rank in Tableau? Yes. You can create a rank by the order that your item are displayed or by any other measures as well. And again, this can also be done using a few simple clicks on your Tableau software. Let's check out how then. So choose your rows and columns from measures and then right click on the measure window and again choose create calculated fields. Now name the field to add the name of the rank. So here we'll name it as rank. Okay. And then under functions drop down, choose option index and then click on okay. And after that, go to the measures and choose the file name and drop it into the row field. And finally, you can see your rank, which was so easy, right? Now let's go ahead. Now, did you know, guys, that you can also highlight any particular field or data on your Tableau view? Yes. And this feature is mainly used whenever you have got a lot of marks on your view. So, highlighter is nothing but a free text field or rather a drop-down menu that can be used to quickly find and highlight your essential data. That means you don't really need a parameter or a color legend to find what you are looking for. And therefore, it does not clutter or alter your visualization. And again, to highlight your text, you can simply open your dashboard and click on Actions. And after that, in the Actions dialog box, click the Add Action button and then select Highlight. Now a dialog box pops up, so you can simply name it, you know, in order to identify it. And then use the drop-down list to select the source data of yours. And finally, you will get your highlighted data. Okay, now let's go ahead. Now if you have worked with Tableau, then you must have spent a lot of time trying to get dashboards to fit each screen on different devices, right? And to do this, you would need or you would end up compromising with the content of the dashboard. However, Tableau 10 provides you an interesting feature called multi-screen device sizing, which will allow you to create a dashboard that fits across all devices, just like mobiles, tablets, and desktop screen size, etc. And this can be done in just a few clicks. Let me show you guys. So you open any dashboard, click on device preview on the left side, and then you can choose the device type and model, and your dashboard will be ready to display on specific devices, which is so great. Now another feature on the list is cross data source filtering. So Tableau updated version provides a new feature for cross data source filtering, and using this, you can filter across multiple data sources without using a tedious parameter, right? So wherever you have a workbook that contains more than one data source, which have various common fields, you can use this functionality. For example, the dashboard on the screen shows the order quantity, average sales, and average profit for customers. Okay, so it has got 3 views. Now each of the views uses a different data source as its primary data source. And those data sources will have a field in common, and that is customer name. And to filter this, right click on the field on the filter shelf and then select apply to worksheets and then choose all using related data sources, just like shown on the screen. And then after doing all this, the resultant will be as shown on screen. Okay. Now again, another advantage of using this feature is that it provides flexibility to customize your dashboards as well. So this actually is a great feature to know and work with. Now let's go ahead. So next on our list is animated visualization. So did you know, guys, about animated visualization in Tableau? So animated visualization technique has recently gained new prominence for presentations, and this will help the presenter to engage the audience, and again, it helps to understand the results of an analysis more effectively because it is visually more appealing, right? Now, how do you really do this in Tableau? So let me just quickly tell you guys how you actually can do it. So once the data is loaded on the worksheet, open Show Me toolbar using Show Me button and simultaneously pressing the Control key. Now click on Product from Dimensions and Sales from Measures. And again, go to Show Me toolbar and click on horizontal bars icon. Now drag and drop date from dimensions into the page shelf. Then repeat the step to show graphs by quarters. And now you just have to click on play button to animate it. That simple it was, right? Let's go ahead. Now let me tell you guys another interesting facts about Tableau. And that is, Tableau is really a very much clever tool in which you can do any operations just by using drag and drop functions. However, did you know that when you drag and drop, Tableau writes a query language? Yes. So when you drag and drop any function in Tableau, so Tableau is actually taking or rather talking to your data using SQL to shape the results from your data sources. So you might be thinking that why do I really need to know about this? But then whenever you are stuck, you don't really know what fields to use or how to configure them. Then ask yourself, what would you have done without Tableau, or what are the steps used in database or spreadsheets? So working through such a solution often helps you to discover the missing link you need in Tableau. But then, it does not mean that you have to be an expert in database and SQL in order to work with Tableau. Without the knowledge of SQL, you can also become a Tableau expert. However, having a bit knowledge of data analysis background will help you to accelerate your Tableau knowledge. Let's go ahead now. Now we also know that table calculation is one of the most powerful and complex tools used in Tableau, right? However, understanding the little bit of theory about partitioning and addressing will help you work with table calculation effortlessly. Let's see that. So what is addressing and partitioning? So addressing is a field that defines what part of the table you are computing along. And partitioning field helps you to group the calculation. So addressing and partitioning can be a very powerful tool to manipulate your views and data. But then care should also be taken that you are arranging the addressing and partitioning fields in the correct way. And after that, let's move on to our last feature. So have you guys seen this blue and green things on Tableau? Well, so most of us think that blue or green color indicates measures or dimensions, which is not true. The color here is actually used to indicate the fields that are discrete and continuous. So blue fields in Tableau refers to discrete nature, which includes finite numbers of value. For example, the field region might include only north, south, east, and west. Whereas green fields in Tableau refers to fields that are continuous and includes infinite number of values. For example, again, the price of an item where it can be any value along the number line, right? So it's continuous but then infinite as well. So discrete and continuous fields are treated in very different ways when used to create a Tableau view. And hence, it is important to know how Tableau behaves. And that is why it was important for you guys also to know about this feature of Tableau. And with this, we have reached to the end of the video. So there's actually a lot to take in there. However, I have just listed some main features or points. So hope you guys have enjoyed the video and learned some of the beautiful features of this beautiful tool called Tableau. And now do take advantage of the career opportunities that come with the expertise in these tools and upgrade your skills with Intellipaat online professional training programs, which is one of the best e-learning platforms. So here you can get a 360 degree knowledge about the course designed by the best of the industry experts. Thank you so much for watching this video and giving us your precious time. For any inquiries, feel free to contact us.
I hope the video was informative for you. Please like the video, and if you have any doubts, comment below. We shall respond to it at the earliest. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more such informative videos. Do look out for other related videos in our playlist. For more detailed information, visit our website now. Have a great day and career ahead.